Welcome to today's deep dive into one of the strangest and rarest groups of mammals, Desmans. These elusive semi-aquatic insectivores are the last surviving members of an ancient lineage that once spanned Europe, Asia, and even North America. With their long snorkel-like snouts and webbed feet, they are sometimes likened as the platypuses of the mole world. But despite their odd charm, Desmans are in serious trouble. Habitat loss, pollution, and invasive species have left them hanging on by a thread. In this video, we'll explore their evolutionary history, dive into their place on the mammal family tree, and examine their unique biology and the conservation struggles that they face. If you're interested in learning more, check out the description for a document with research papers and image credits. To understand where Desmans fit in the grand scheme of mammal evolution, we need to take a step back and explore the larger picture of mammalian ancestry. Desmans are placental mammals, meaning they give birth to live young after a relatively long gestation period. This group includes everything from whales to rodents. Within this broad category, Desmans belong to the order Eulipotyphla, a more specialized group within the placental mammals. Placental mammals are divided into several major branches or clades. Here's a quick breakdown. First, we have Xenartha and Afrotheria, ancient groups with some of the strangest animals around, like sloths, anteaters, elephants, and aardvarks. Then come Glaries and Euarchonta, home to rodents, rabbits, primates, and tree shrews. Following that clade, we have the one that we are most interested in today, Eulipotyphla. This split off early in mammal evolution, long before the rise of many well-known groups like bats, carnivores, or hoofed mammals. Though often overlooked, they hold deep evolutionary significance. Beyond Eulipotyphla, we see other clades, like Chiroptera, the bats, the only mammals to achieve powered flight, and the second largest order of mammals today. Ferae, which includes Carnivora, with dogs, cats, bears, and seals, and Philodota, with the pangolins. And finally, Euangulata, or the hoofed mammals, which splits into Perissodactyla, with the horses, rhinos, and tapirs, and Artiodactyla, with everything from pigs and deer to giraffes, cows, and even whales. While they may not be the oldest of the placental mammals, Desmans are part of a unique evolutionary branch that holds significant clues about the early diversification of mammals. Their place on the tree reflects a fascinating period in mammalian history where diverse groups were just beginning to carve out their ecological niches. This brings us to the group we're most interested in today, Eulipotyphla, a lineage that, despite often being overlooked, is the third largest mammalian order, only behind bats and rodents. These are primarily insectivores, small, secretive, and often underappreciated by the public. For much of their history, these animals were lumped together in the now outdated order Insectivora. This grouping made sense because they were all small, insect-eating mammals, but genetic studies showed that Insectivora was a mess, full of unrelated lineages that had just evolved similar lifestyles due to convergent evolution. Eulipotyphla, on the other hand, represents a natural group, one that diverged into two natural branches more than 70 million years ago, during the time of the dinosaurs. While many prehistoric families are known, their exact relationships are still debated, so let's focus on the more modern groups to understand this lineage. Nesophontidae, or the West Indian shrews, lived on Caribbean islands like Cuba and Hispaniola. They are the one group I will include that are now extinct. They couldn't survive the arrival of rats and other invasive species brought by European ships. Within a few centuries, maybe even decades, they were wiped out. The last likely vanished in the 1500s. Although some may have survived into later centuries, they are definitely gone now. They are a reminder of the danger posed by invasive species, a reality that Desmans are struggling to come to terms with today. Selenodons, another relic group from the same early branch, are only found on Caribbean islands. These nocturnal, burrowing mammals are most well known for possessing a trait rare amongst mammals, venom. Sericidae, or the shrews, make up the bulk of Eulipotyphla diversity. With nearly 400 species, they are found nearly worldwide. Known for their voracious appetites, this has required some countries to mandate that small animal traps include shrew escape routes because these tiny creatures can starve to death in just a few hours. Then there are the hedgehogs and moon rats in Erinaceidae. They showcase both ancient traits and bizarre adaptations, helping to illustrate the diversity of Eulipotyphla. If you want a deeper dive into hedgehogs, check out my video on that group. That brings us to Talpidae, the mole family. Given moles are well known for digging, it might be surprising, but this is where Desmans also fit in, having evolved to thrive in semi-aquatic environments instead. Talpidae has three subfamilies. The Asian shrew-like moles of Eulipotyphla are only found in the high alpine regions of China, Myanmar, and Vietnam. Although they look very similar to shrews, their skeletons provide a hint to their true relationship. They have a full zygomatic arch, the bone that forms the cheek. Moles have one as well, but true shrews don't. The subfamily Scaloponae, or the New World moles, are a small group of moles found in North America and China. They are built for digging underground, with large spade-like claws and very poor eyesight. Talpidae is the largest subfamily. This contains a mixture of Old World moles, shrew moles, and the Desmans. The Desmans were the group of them that diverged the earliest, forming the tribe Desmanini. Desmans may only have two living species today, but their fossil record tells a much richer story. They first appeared over 20 million years ago, during the early Miocene, likely evolving from mole-like ancestors. Over time, they adapted to life in freshwater habitats, rivers, lakes, and streams. This aquatic lifestyle allowed them to thrive across Europe, Asia, and even North America. Fossils show that Desmans were once more widespread, though never very abundant. North American Desmans, for instance, are the rarest Miocene mammals, with only scattered teeth and skull fragments, providing evidence of their existence. These North American species disappeared around 3 to 5 million years ago, leaving only their distant cousins behind. The genus Desmana included the most known species, one of which still survives today as the Russian Desman. The other living genus, Gallimes, included several extinct species, with the Pyrenean Desman being the last of its line. These two surviving species are the remnants of a once diverse group of semi-aquatic moles. As habitats changed and competition increased, Desmans retreated into smaller and more isolated pockets. Today, only two fragile populations remain, each clinging to the edges of a rapidly changing world. Now, let's focus on the first of these survivors, the Pyrenean Desman, Gallimes pyrenaicus, also known as the Iberian Desman. This small mammal is found in the northern and central regions of Portugal and Spain, the French Pyrenees, and Andorra. Measuring about 11 to 14 centimeters, or 4 to 5.5 inches long, it has a long, flattened tail, roughly the same length as its body, which aids in swimming. Like all Desmans, the Pyrenean Desman is highly adapted to its semi-aquatic lifestyle. Its large, partially webbed feet help it swim through fast-moving streams. Its dense, water-repellent fur traps air, providing buoyancy and insulation when submerged. The Desman also has specialized nostrils and ear flaps that automatically close when it dives into the water, preventing water from entering its respiratory system. The most distinctive feature of the Pyrenean Desman is its long, flexible snout, covered in many sensory whiskers and Eimer's organs, specialized touch receptors found in moles that allow Desmans to detect movement on the riverbed. This adaptation helps it find prey, even in murky or dark conditions. Desmans have a weak form of electroreception, enabling them to sense the electrical fields produced by its prey. Some researchers have suggested that Eimer's organs may contribute to this ability, but the exact source of their electroreception remains uncertain. For years, it was believed that the Pyrenean Desman's diet consisted mostly of aquatic invertebrates. However, recent research has shown that it's a generalist insectivore, eating a variety of prey. A study in 2017 found massive diet variety, including 70 taxa that they were previously unknown to eat. The most common species in its diet remains those with aquatic larvae, mayflies, caddisflies, and stoneflies. These three are interesting choices, as they are the exact taxa used by freshwater ecologists to determine the health of waterways, since they are reliable indicators of clean, well-oxygenated water. This strongly implies that the Desmans' habitat consists of cold, fast-flowing, unpolluted mountain streams, where these insects are common. Contrary to earlier beliefs, the Pyrenean Desman is not particularly territorial. Studies have shown that multiple Desmans can share resting places without signs of aggression, suggesting a more social behavior than previously thought. Still, much remains unknown about their social structure, and ongoing research is working to fill in these gaps. Another area still shrouded in uncertainty is the Pyrenean Desman's breeding behaviour. They build nests tucked into riverbanks with underwater entrances that offer a natural defence against predators. Their mating system appears to be promiscuous. Both males and females may molt with multiple partners, though there's some suggestion it might be weakly polygynous, with males taking multiple mates more often than females do. Regardless of the system, males take no role in raising the young, and no long-term bonds form between the partners. Sadly, despite their fascinating biology, Pyrenean Desmans are listed as endangered by the IUCN. A quick look at their current distribution tells the story. Much of their former range has been lost or marked as possibly extinct, leaving their habitat increasingly fragmented and restricted. The main culprit? Human disturbance. Lower altitude rivers have been heavily altered, riparian vegetation removed, waters polluted, forcing Desmans to retreat to colder, cleaner headwaters of mountain streams. Though they're capable of living anywhere from sea level up to 2,700 metres or almost 9,000 feet, their range is now skewed increasingly towards high altitudes, where conditions are still relatively pristine. But the pressures they face aren't just from habitat loss. Invasive species have added a new layer of threat. The American mink, introduced to the Iberian Peninsula in the 1970s and 80s, is a highly effective predator of small mammals and has severely impacted Desman populations. Meanwhile, introduced crayfish don't prey on Desmans, but they compete with them for food and shelter. Worse, these crayfish disturb the riverbeds, increasing siltation and degrading the very waterways Desmans depend on. In fact, the Pyrenean Desmans' endangered status is a recent escalation. They were listed as vulnerable as recently as 2020. In some areas, populations have plummeted by as much as 87% over the past 3 decades. Much of this decline directly mirrors the spread of invasive species like the American mink, which often signals the rapid disappearance of Desmans wherever it becomes established. If you thought there was still a lot we don't know about the Pyrenean Desman, meet its larger and even more mysterious cousin, the Russian Desman, Desmana muscata. This species inhabits several inland river basins in Russia today, though historical records suggest its range once stretched into Ukraine and possibly Kazakhstan, though these populations have not been confirmed in recent decades. In many ways, the Russian Desman is built on the same aquatic blueprint as its Pyrenean relative, but supersized. It measures around 18 to 22 centimeters, or 7 to 8.5 inches, making it almost 1.5 times larger, and it weighs almost 10 times as much. Its tail, long and flattened like the Pyrenean's, is edged with stiff hairs that aid in propulsion and steering. While the Pyrenean Desman relies heavily on its limbs for swimming, the Russian Desman makes greater use of its tail. Its feet are also more specialized, with full webbing between its toes, perfectly suited for life in water. Morphologically, they may be similar, but behaviorally, the Russian Desman sets itself apart, at least as far as we know. Despite their long history of study within Russia, reliable modern research on the Russian Desman is surprisingly sparse, especially outside of the Russian language. Much of what we know today still comes from older Soviet-era studies or local research that's rarely translated. As a result, many aspects of their biology and ecology remain difficult to verify, and much of the current understanding relies on secondary summaries or scattered field reports. That said, the picture that emerges is one of a unique and surprisingly social mammal. Russian Desmans are thought to live in small groups of 2 to 5. These groups can include unrelated individuals, as well as mating pairs or family units. They share a nest, usually with an underwater entrance, and appear to defend loose, overlapping territories. Breeding likely occurs once or twice a year, producing litters of 3 to 5 young. Though monogamy has been suggested, it remains unconfirmed. But, like the Pyrenean cousins, males probably don't contribute to raising offspring. Their social structure may be a direct response to the colder environment. Group living helps conserve warmth and energy through harsh winters. But despite this resilience, the Russian Desman is now critically endangered, having declined by an estimated 83% over the past decade. One of the most pressing threats is accidental bycatch from illegal fishing. Though stationary fishing nets are banned in many areas, they remain common among poachers due to their low cost and durability. These nets are often left unattended or simply abandoned. A trapped Desman only has minutes before it drowns. Other illegal methods, like electric fishing, don't directly kill desmans but can decimate their food sources by stunning and killing aquatic invertebrates. Habitat degradation has also played a significant role in their decline. Pollution, the drainage of wetlands, and the destruction of riverside vegetation have all taken a toll. Unlike the Pyrenean desman, which can retreat to remote mountain streams, the Russian desman is tied to lowland rivers and floodplains, precisely the areas most heavily altered for agriculture and development. These habitats are not only disappearing, but are becoming increasingly unsuitable for survival. As if that weren't enough, competition from invasive species compounds the problem. The American mink has made its way to Russia as well, posing the same predation threat seen in the Pyrenees range. Muskrats, another introduced species, compete for burrows and nesting space, while the Chinese sleeper, a non-native fish, further depletes available invertebrate prey. In an effort to reverse the decline, more than 10,000 Russian desmans have been reintroduced into nature reserves across southern Siberia over the past 70 years. However, the results have been mixed. Many of these sites later experienced their own ecological degradation, plagued by pollution, illegal fishing, and climate change. Still, some success stories do exist. The Oka Nature Reserve, for example, now supports a stable population of around 750 desmans, thanks to strict protections and careful habitat management. But unfortunately, cases like this remain the exception, not the rule. I hope you enjoyed this deep dive into two of the most unusual mammals I've ever covered. Desmans may be small and secretive, but they represent something big, a reminder of how much biodiversity is still out there, quietly clinging on in hidden corners of the world. They face real threats, from habitat loss to invasive species, but with awareness, research, and conservation, this story doesn't have to end here. So, if this video sparked your curiosity, share it, talk about it, and keep learning. The more people who know about animals like the desman, the more chance we have to protect them. Thank you for watching. If there's another fascinating species you'd like to see featured, let me know in the comments below.